So you're looking for your business on Google and you're nowhere to be found. Let me show you how to do an SEO audit of your website. Hey, welcome back to the Entrepreneur Shack. My name is Amanda and I help small business owners learn SEO so you can get more clients. And in today's video, we're talking about how to do an SEO audit of your website so you can figure out where you stand, where your competition stands, and how can you improve. Now, not only am I gonna teach you how to audit your website, but I'm also gonna show you how to audit your competition, figure out where you stand, and what you can do to improve. And if you stay until the very end of this video, I'm gonna tell you how you can get my free SEO checklist. So for today's example, I am using Vanessa Groshong Acupuncture, and this is a local business. So I'll touch on a few points about local SEO. Now, this business is stationed in the city of Edmonton. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna see where this business currently stands in their local market. First things first, it's super important that you open an incognito window. It could also be called private browser or private tab, depending what kind of browser you're using. For this example, I'm using Chrome because I'm also gonna show you some SEO extensions that you can use in your browser. In our incognito window, I'm going to use our keyword, which is Edmonton acupuncturist. If you want to know a little bit more about keywords and how to do keyword research, I'll put a video up here to another video that I did explaining keyword research. So here's our search results for Edmonton acupuncturist. Now, if you look closely, you can see next to these results, this little ad tag. So these first four results have the little ad tag beside them. It means those people are paying to be at the top. We're gonna ignore those because we wanna rank organically, which means for free. And since this is a local business and most people will be searching for a business like this on their phone, we're gonna check where we rank in this Google Places section. So I'm gonna click on more places and let's see where our business is. Again, we're looking for Vanessa Groshong Acupuncture. So I can see the first two are ads, so we're just gonna ignore those. And we just scroll down through the results to see where we're at. At the bottom, we're gonna have to go to the next page. And then I can see that our result is number 3 on the second page. Pause this video really quick and go check where your business lands. Then let me know in the comments below, what page did you find your business on? All right, so now that we know that, why don't we head over to our website and let me show you how to do an SEO audit of your website and figure out what it is that we can do to actually improve. So in order to do these things that I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna be using a Chrome extension. It was a little piece of software that you can get for free. If you go to Chrome Web Store, it is called Open SEO Stats. And it gives you this little icon in your web browser. So let's quickly take a look at our page and let's use our extension. So I'm using the Page Info tab. And what I wanna do is I wanna check my key elements to see if I have my keyword in those key elements. Now, if you're not sure what the key elements are, don't worry, I have a free SEO checklist that you can grab down in the description below. And so each time that you wanna optimize a page for a keyword, you can just follow the checklist. Also, pay real close attention to what I'm explaining to you here because you can use this exact same technique to audit your competition on the next step. So I'm gonna breeze through these really quickly because you have the checklist you can refer to. We're gonna look at our title. Our title does have Edmonton acupuncturist in it. Our description also has Edmonton acupuncturist in it. We have about 5 external links, 7 internal links. Our headings, H1 and H2, so there's 2 levels, H1 is the highest, do not have our keyword in them. Our stylized text also doesn't have our keyword. Our alt text, or also known as alternative text, is for our images, which is also not present. And then for the body, you can see there's 3,000 words here. This obviously is not 3,000 words. So what I do is I quickly go onto the page and I Command F or Control F if you're on a PC and just search for Edmonton acupuncturist. So I can see here, it doesn't come up. So that means the body of our page does not have the keyword Edmonton acupuncturist. So that's really important to understand. Now the next thing that I wanna touch on is those links that I quickly mentioned. So if you click on link stats, you can actually see where all of the page's external and internal links are going to. So external links are from outside websites. This can be other practitioners. This can be like, let's say, an association website. It can also be your social media website. It can be people who are linking to you for some reason because maybe you're an expert. Essentially, the more trusted external links you have, the better. So for example, Huffington Post is a massive website and it's highly trusted. So if you had a link coming to your website from them, that is going to give your website a boost in trust with Google and therefore rank you higher in search engine. Now, diving deep into backlinking is a little bit beyond this video, so make sure you hit subscribe and the bell icon so you can see when I post new videos about that. But I have actually worked out a little bit of my own proprietary point system that you can use. I'll explain that in the next step. The next thing we want to check really quickly is the page speed. So here I can see that the page loads in about 2.4 seconds. Google also has its own speed test. So you can actually put your website right into Google speed test and it will analyze it for you. Now I should quickly mention here, don't get too hung up on the speed test because you'll drive yourself crazy trying to get your speed faster. In 2018, average speed load was about 15 seconds. Now in 2019, it is 10 seconds and it's only going to get faster. I'll drop a link to the Google speed test down in the description below for you. If Google ranks your website 50 or higher, give this video a thumbs up. And if it ranks you below 50, give the video a thumbs down. All right, so next we're gonna dive really quick into our competition and see what we can do to improve. So let's go back to page one and ignoring our ads, let's take the links to our top competitors. So I can just right click and copy that link address over into my regular browser. And you have to do that into the regular browser, not the incognito, because otherwise your extension won't work. All right, so I just quickly went and grabbed the first three results here and we're gonna use our Chrome extension. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use my point system. So for every key element that this website has, Edmonton acupuncturist, not to be confused with Edmonton acupuncture, those are two different words, we're gonna give each of those elements 4 points. So again, if you forget what those key elements are, make sure you go grab the checklist down in the description there, and then you can follow along. So your title, does it have Edmonton acupuncturist? Your meta description, does it have your keyword? No. External links, for every external link, you're gonna give it 2 points. And for every internal link, you're gonna give it 1 point. Header one, header two, bold italic, alt image text, body text. So if I were to add up all the points for this particular site, we've got 38 internal, we've got 9 external, that's 9 times 2, and we've got 0 key elements with Edmonton acupuncturist. Our total for this competitor is 56 points. So now we can go to our other competitors and see again and add up those points. Now, let's say we optimize each of our key elements. That's approximately 5 or 6 elements with 4 points. That's only 20 points. We're still only half as good as the 56 points. Now, Vanessa Grosjean Acupuncture also has 6 external links. That's 2 points, that's 12 points, it's still only 32 points. So as you can see from my point system and what I've explained is there's a few things that you can do, such as optimizing your key elements, increasing your page speed, getting some more backlinks. This is how you can beat that score and begin to rank higher in the search results. Now I couldn't possibly go over every single thing that you can do. But if you want to learn more about SEO strategies, make sure you grab my SEO checklist down in the description below, and I'll invite you to my SEO for Bosses Facebook group. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.